Hello viewers, welcome to this video on cluster analysis. You might be aware that cluster analysis is a classification technique. In cluster analysis, we try to classify the objects, cases, or also called as respondents into some groups based on some variables on which these cases have been measured. The classification is actually done based on the similarities these cases share and the variables of measurement. So the central idea of cluster analysis is to group the cases or respondents into relatively homogeneous characteristics with the members in the same group, and they share relatively heterogeneous characteristics with the members of the other group. So the groups are called the clusters. And to summarize, each cluster is homogeneous within, but it is distinct from other. So the aim of cluster analysis is to achieve maximum homogeneity of the objects within the clusters and maximum heterogeneity between the clusters. There is a similarity and a difference between cluster analysis and factor analysis. The cluster analysis and factor analysis are similar in that in both the analysis, we don't have the dependence and independence nature of the variables. In both the analysis, all the variables are interdependent, and both the techniques are some sort of classification or grouping techniques. These are the similarities between cluster analysis and factor analysis. Whereas the differences are that in factor analysis, we group the items, or sometimes loosely called as variables also. Whereas in cluster analysis, the objects or the respondents or the cases are grouped. And we group the items in factor analysis to obtain the factors or constructs or components. Whereas in cluster analysis, the cases are grouped to obtain the clusters. And the grouping in cluster analysis is done based on the distance between the objectives, whereas the grouping in factor analysis is done based on the inter-item correlations. So these are the differences between factor analysis and cluster analysis. To make these differences understood better, let us look at some kind of data like this. Let us say the data that we see on the screen are a study where the researcher has some data on m items from n respondents. Let us look at the data in the following table to understand the difference between cluster analysis and factor analysis better. The data is of a researcher who has collected some data on m items from n respondents. So in a tabular form, it will look like the one that you see on the screen. And if we are using factor analysis, we'll classify or reduce the m items that you see horizontally into some factors. So the items are grouped in factor analysis. If we are doing a cluster analysis on this data, we try to classify the n respondents, which are also called as n cases or n objects, into some clusters. The cluster analysis is also referred to sometimes as a classification analysis, queue analysis, a typology construction, and numerical taxonomy. These are different names the cluster analysis sometimes referred to as. Now, let us look at the three steps in conducting the cluster analysis. The step one is choosing a similarity measure. We have already noted that the clusters are formed based on the similarity between the objects. And the similarity is nothing but the shared characteristics, because these respondents are objects have certain characteristics or some variables on which they have been measured, then based on how much similarity is shared by objects on these measures, we try to cluster them. So we need to find out a way by which, you know, we'll try to measure the similarity between the objectives. That is step number one. And we need to choose a clustering procedure. There are several clustering procedures to start with, you know, hierarchical clustering and non-hierarchical clustering. And within each of these two broad categories, there are a few other subdivisions. We will be looking at them in a minute from now. And finally, we need to decide on the number of clusters. So this is the three-step procedure for conducting the cluster analysis. And before we proceed to understand these three steps, because these steps involve a little bit of jargon, so I would rather start with an example and do a clustering based on some intuitive approach, and then we'll come back to these methods and try to understand them.